hours, night starts to lean.
Cut it out.
I'm going to Mali.
Catherine. Yes, let me go.
I'll drop you.
No, you won't if you help me up.
Help you up? Now that I've got you right where I want you? Wedding fever. I just got back from the airport where I picked up the voice in the steel band.
Yes.
Mon, these guys are absolutely fantastic. Do you know, if it hadn't been for them, I'd still be eating passion fruit down there with good old Cecile.
Cass, just settle down. We have a lot to figure out.
Oh, I know. Like, do we seat the boys in the band next to the Sisters of St. Mary's?
Cass, I'm serious.
So am I. Then afterwards, the boys in the band will play for us at the reception, and the Sisters of St. Mary's will sing.
Shut up, please.
Okay.
We've got problems.
What?
About the wedding. Are you okay?
Oh, man, the chimney must be backed up or something. How's dinner coming?
Okay. Well, I hope you like baked beans.
Well, if you're cooking, I'm eating.
You think anyone will see the smoke and rescue us?
Maybe, but at least we got a roof over our heads until morning. By then, your ankle ought to be better, huh?
Oh, it better be. I'm in Kathleen's wedding tomorrow.
Don't worry. We're going to get you there. Besides, we have a perfect excuse for being out all night.
I guess so.
Hey, look, we're lucky we even have this place, you know.
Yeah, well, there's only one problem.
What's that?
Only one sleeping bed.
Thought winning was everything to you, Reg. I mean, isn't that why you took Mary McKinnon in the first place?
How dare you?
That was the only way you could get her, right?
What did my wife tell you?
She said she never wants to see you again, Reg. Ever. She said her love for you is dead. How sweet is your victory now, Reg?
No!
Are you all right? Honey. Oh. Are you hurt, huh?
I'm fine.
I was so afraid you were hurt. What happened?
I thought...
For a moment there, Donna, I thought you'd lost your mind.
Donna, how could you run in front of a loaded weapon like that? Somebody could have gotten hurt.
You're
you could
right.
have been killed.
I know.
Let's get you up.
I don't know what's happening to you, Donna.
I'm sorry, Daddy.
We're friends. I'm afraid the contest is over. Since it's getting dark, I'm afraid I'll have to concede defeat. Thank you all very much for coming. Thank you. Looks like you've won the day, Hudson.
Wait a minute, Reg. I want an explanation.
Michael, just forget that this happened.
No, wait a minute. I want to know why you said that.
What are you talking about?
I'm sure she didn't know what she was saying.
You said Reginald tried to kill me again. No, look, Reg, why did you say again? Why did she say again?
I haven't a clue.
Michael, please, I don't know why I said I was just being foolish.
Judging from her actions, Donna has a very vivid imagination, just like her mother.
Could we just drop this?
You've already ruined the entire outing.
Senor, can you please step inside?
What is it now, Gomez?
It's a very urgent matter requiring your attention.
Very well.
Lucky, tell me, I want an explanation.
Michael, please!
No, you said again. You think he tried to kill me before? What?
Mr. Michael.
Bridget.
Mr. Michael, you got a phone call. It's very important, they said.
What is it?
What does she want?
You little devil. You're going to have somebody kidnap you off that altar and whisk you away down to the Virgin Islands,
Cass,
aren't you?
Will you please be serious?
Honey, it's been done. What?
My mother is in the next room.
Okay, all right, okay.
Look, Pops came by here earlier.
Oh. To see Mary?
Yeah.
And did they talk about the wedding?
Yeah. Doesn't look very hopeful. I don't think that he's going to let her come.
Well, we figured that Vince wouldn't buy this, didn't we? Is your mother really upset?
She says she expected him to react that way, but I can tell it's breaking her heart.
And yours, too.
Well, what are we supposed to do? I mean, she's staying here with us. What do we do tomorrow? Do we hand her a mop and tell her to clean up the kitchen while we go get married?
Yeah. Yeah, we got a problem.
Why does everything always have to be this way? Why can't anything work out for once?
Hey, don't cave in on me now.
I feel helpless, Cass. I mean, she's my mother. I love her.
But you love Vince, too. And when he makes up his mind to do something...
Yeah, I know. Forget it. I should have known it was impossible.
Please. Try not to get upset.
I built this dumb, unrealistic fantasy that my mother and father could get together and we'd have the most beautiful wedding ceremony.
And we will. I promise you, we will. Okay?
I'm sorry. I shouldn't be laying all of this on you. Not fair to you.
Hey. I'll do anything I can.
Might as well just face it.
What are you doing now?
Calling Father O'Connor.
What for?
I'm going to ask him to drop the candlelight ceremony.
Wait just a second. No.
Kev, what is the point? You just said yourself that when Pops makes up his mind, that is it.
I have an idea. You just sit tight.
What about Father O'Connor?
I'll be back in about an hour.
Where are you going?
I suppose it's big enough for two. I'll be just fine over here by the fire.
I'm not gonna let you sleep on the floor, Scott.
I used to do it all the time when I was in camp.
You went to camp too?
Yeah, my parents used to take me to Yosemite every summer.
I went to camp with the nuns. Talk about a total drag.
No boys, huh?
No, nothing. I'm surprised they even let us wear bathing suits.
That's right, the nuns probably never wore bathing suits, do they?
No, except, what was her name? Sister Herman Joseph.
Herman Joseph,
yeah,
no way.
Our swimming instructor. We used to call her Sister Mark Spitz. Oh, my gosh.
Oh, what's that smell?
I think it's our dinner.
Oh, man.
Come here.
That don't look too bad.
Yeah, what do you think of charcoal broiled beans, huh?
Well, maybe they're okay. Let me give it a try, huh?
Okay.
No, that's good stuff, Cheryl.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's so good, I'm going to give you a try of this.
No. You're just saying
no,
that.
No, it really is. It's terrific. Here you go. Mmm.
Oh,
huh?
Oh, yeah. That is so disgusting. And you did it on purpose,
no, I didn't.
Didn't you?
No,
you had it all planned.
No, I didn't. Okay, I got lousy taste buds, all right?
Oh, sense of humor, you big dope.
I'm going to get you down.
Hey, Rudy, look what I found here.
What are you doing here? You want to blow my cover?
Say, what's a person got to do to get a drink around here anyway?
Take a walk.
Hey, wait a minute. Don't I know you from somewhere? I bet you hear that line all the time, don't you?
Why don't you just walk a line right out that door?
Sassy, ain't you?
Are you crazy?
Yeah, that's some nice greeting.
How did you even know I was here?
I was down at the station, remember? And I overheard some of the guys talking about, what a cute little outfit you had on today.
I cannot believe those guys.
Hot, MJ. Really hot.
What are you doing here?
Well, I just thought I'd check the place out. It's colorful. And it's a little, little rough, but it's colorful.
I am undercover. I can't even know you.
So treat me like any other customer, and I'll get to know you. There's nothing suspicious about that.
Why are you doing this?
Because somebody besides those toy cops you got stationed out front have got to keep an eye on you.
So you elected yourself?
You got nothing better to do on my break.
Don't do me any favors.
And to think we broke up years ago because you went undercover. I sure hoped it'd be a better gig than this.
Will you go already?
I'll be back after my shift in the yard.
No, you won't.
Just to drive you home. I mean, you know, as friends, with those drinks.
Thanks.
but no thanks.
You sure are looking good these days. Just like that Catholic high school girl I used to know and love.
So how was your skeet shoot?
Long.
How was your day?
Okay.
Just okay?
I saw Mitch. I talked to him for a while, but I didn't get any answers.
What kind of answers?
I'm just trying to figure out about the two of you, Mom, okay?
What do you want to know?
Will other kids' mothers and fathers still love each other?
Matthew, we've been all through this.
Do you still love Mitch, Mom?
Absolutely not.
Why, did he say I did?
No.
Good. At least he was being honest.
Is that what you're being?
Matthew?
Are you sure you're not just saying that because Mac would get mad?
Listen to me. I love Mac very much. I always have and I always will. Now, can we change the subject, please?
Well, Mitch sure loves you.
Did he say that?
No, not exactly. Grown-ups never say what they feel. I'm going upstairs to finish my homework.
Will you be having dinner then?
Oh, no, thank you, Jeanette. We had plenty to eat at the Loves. I might take a drive, though. It's beautiful along Bayview Boulevard this time of year.
But it'll be getting dark soon.
It's the best time. It's beautiful at dusk.
What do you guys want?
We were fixing the sack out here for the night, kid.
Sorry, guys, we beat you to it.
Well, kid doesn't have too much respect for his elders, does he?
Well, maybe we ought to teach him a lesson.
No!
Easy, easy.
Oh, you hear that, Polly? Don't she have a lovely little voice?
Look, guys, hey. We saw the cabin first, so it's ours, right? Unless you can give us a ride back to Bay City.
You hear that? What, are you kids on the lam or something?
Ran our car into a ditch.
Oh, ain't that a shame.
Suppose you could give us a ride to a phone?
Our truck's back at the Bay City line.
Great.
We hiked 10 miles today. Yeah, and 10 miles yesterday and 10 the day before that.
That's what you call knowing how to survive.
Good for you.
Yeah, know how to have a good time.
Get your hands off of her.
That's okay, Scott.
Hey, Rudy. I bet you these kids were running off to get married or something, right, honey?
Yeah, that's right. Scott and I were going to get married, but our parents wouldn't let us.
What'd I tell you?
Look, why don't you guys just go do some hunting?
You telling us what to do, kid?
You heard it.
Look, you want trouble, you got it.
Now look, you guys don't want to get in trouble with the cops now, do you?
There ain't no cops around here, son.
Oh, yeah, there is. They're looking for us. We got an APB out on us.
Oh, really?
We better not stick around to find out.
I ain't no hurry.
Hey, come on, Rudy. It's getting dark outside. We're gonna be tripping all over ourselves trying to find that campsite over on Lookout Point. Are you coming or what?
You have a real nice honeymoon now, you hear?
I thought they were gonna kill us.
You all right? They didn't hurt you, did they?
Thanks to you. Now, I hate to admit it, but you're pretty brave back there. That one guy had a gun pointing straight at you.
They were just trying to spook us.
They sure were mean and ugly.
I know. See that one guy? Look like Bigfoot, huh? Trembling.
The fireplace.
Come on, let's get out of here.
Cheryl, isn't she supposed to work tonight?
Come on, let me buy you a cup of coffee, Ada.
Oh, sure.
Look.
Listen, is Cheryl here or not?
I don't know. She's probably still at the house. Come on, lighten up, Vince.
All right, what's on your mind, Cass?
Well, nothing. I thought that we would, you know...
Just a cup of coffee. Spit it out, okay?
Thank you, Ada.
You're welcome.
Snack. Can we, have a friendly chat here?
It's about Mary, isn't it?
Well, now that you mention it.
It's about her coming to the wedding, right?
Well, yeah, Kathleen and I have been talking about that.
Listen, I like you, Cass, but just stay out of this one, okay?
Hey, come on, Vince. Now, be fair. I've always done everything I can not to step on your toes. I've tried to be... Well, I've tried to keep things nice and simple between the two of us. But I gotta tell you this time, I think you're wrong.
Listen, I do not want to hear anything about Mary coming to that wedding, and that is fine.
Hey, sit down. I'm a member of this family too now, you know. We're both the men of the family, and I'm just trying to do what's best for everybody concerned.
And you don't think I am?
There's a lot at stake here. Not just your happiness, but Kathleen's, too. Not to mention the rest of the family. How about Cheryl? How is she going to feel about all of this?
Cheryl has gotten along without her mother all these years. She'll do just fine.
I'm not going to beg. I just want to lay it all out in the line.
All right. Say what you have to say.
I know you're hurting. You're made of flesh and blood just like all the rest of us. No, there's nothing to be ashamed about. And I know that Mary put you through a lot with this affair that she had with Reginald Love. Come on, Vince. It's been 17 years.
Not to me, Cass. To me, it seems like just yesterday.
Mary knows she made a big mistake.
That does not change the fact.
What is this? You've never made a mistake? Now, come on. Maybe you should start thinking about other people here. Like Kathleen, it's her wedding.
Are you through?
No, I have one more thing to say.
Well, spit it out quickly, because I've had enough of this.
If you don't let Mary come to this wedding, to our wedding, you could be making a mistake. A mistake that you'll regret for the rest of your life. I think that's what you should be concentrating on right now, not something that happened 17 years ago. Vince, it's over and done with, all right? So live for the present before that's gone, too.
What's that all about?
Oh, boy, when I blow it, Ada, I really blow it big. He's probably not going to let me come to the wedding either.
You think you've got problems.
Oh, great. What now?
Scott and Cheryl are missing.
What?
Nobody has seen them since this morning.
What do you think was up there?
I don't know. The trees blocked out most of the moonlight, but I know something stopped at that chimney up there.
Think maybe it's some leaves or something?
Could be. Or maybe a nest. Whatever it was, it fell down and stopped up the flue. So much for a cozy fire, huh?
Yeah.
Are you cold?
Yeah, a little.
Go ahead and get in the sleeping bag over there.
Yeah, but what about you?
I'm okay. I got my jacket on.
Hey. You know, we're going to have to get a real early start tomorrow.
Yeah, your family must be worried sick about you, huh?
Yeah. No, we've got to get back in time for Kathleen's wedding.
Don't worry. I'm going to get you back if I have to carry you, okay? Wait till Vince finds out we spent the night together. Man. Hey, check it out. Got any matches?
Yeah, over there by the stove.
I sure hope Vince is in a good mood tomorrow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Would you really have had a fight with those guys to save me?
They weren't gonna hurt you.
But if they did, they did try to hurt me, would you?
You know I would have. I'm just glad I didn't have to do it. Could have killed a moose with that gun he had, you know?
No. It's pretty cold in here.
Would you get in the sleeping bag before you get so sick you won't be able to go to the wedding? Now, come on, get in.
You know, when I was in Girl Scouts, they used to tell us not to sleep with any clothes on.
Or you'd wake up even colder, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, if you don't want me to watch you get undressed, I won't.
You know, it never did make much sense to me anyway. I think it's not such a great idea after all. Scott?
Is it okay?
Yeah. You know, there's plenty of room here.
No.
Are you sure you don't want to?
Yeah, it's no problem. I'm not even cold. I'm okay.
Are you sure?
Really? No, I'm fine. Yeah.
Yeah, these are really great.
Look, I didn't mean to get you worked up earlier.
No, it's okay. It wasn't your fault.
And what I mean is I don't want you to feel that you've got to choose between me or your mom.
All I wanted were some straight answers. But I talked to Mom and she was the same way. She wouldn't tell me anything either.
Where is she, anyway?
I'm not sure. She was here a little while ago. Dad brought her back after the skeet shoot.
Your TV program is on, Matthew.
Oh, thanks, Jeanette. You want to come upstairs and watch with me?
Maybe another time.
Okay. Thanks a lot for the books.
Where is Mrs. Gore?
Out for a drive, Mr. Blake.
Do you know where she went?
I think she said Bayview Boulevard.
Bayview Boulevard? Thank you.
How sweet is your victory now, Reg?
You should have told the servants to let me in. I mean, you gave me no choice but to climb up the trellis.
What are you going to get into your head that I don't want you around here anymore?
Hey, save it for the Academy Awards, all right? What am I going to do with you?
Michael, you can't be here.
Look, you're afraid, right? You're afraid.
No, I'm not.
Yeah? Then why did you knock the gun out of Reginald's hand?
I told you I was just being silly. It was
no, you were
the shooting and
you
the gun.
You were afraid then and you're afraid now.
Michael, if you care anything about me, would you please do as I say?
He threatened me, didn't he? He said he'd kill me.
You don't understand.
Yes, I do understand. Honey, I understand only too well.
You have to leave here now.
I'm not leaving until you level with me.
Is it your ego? You just can't accept the fact that I don't want you in my life anymore.
And that's why you jumped in front of a loaded shotgun, because you don't want me in your life anymore, huh?
I'm not going to take this cross-examination.
Donna, he threatened me. He threatened to kill me. I know it. He said unless you called off the wedding, he'd kill me. Isn't that why you won't marry me?
No.
Admit it to
no.
me.
No, Michael.
You are running scared now. Tell me. Admit it.
Yes, I don't want him to hurt you, Michael. Please, listen to me, please.
Honey, look. I know you've been going through this alone, okay? But not any longer. You don't have to go through it alone anymore. Now that it's out in the open, we can deal with it.
We can't deal with it, Michael. Daddy will kill you.
No,
to
no,
punish
no.
me.
He won't. He can't. Honey, he's not invulnerable. He can't just go around killing people.
But he does what he wants to. He always has.
Not this time. He's only human. He's not gonna win. Look, I smoked him out of hiding, didn't I?
Do you think he's gonna let you get away with that?
He doesn't have a choice in the matter. He's on his way down, honey. He's defeated. He couldn't even shoot straight this afternoon.
That's not the same thing.
Okay, then what about Mary? Huh? He lost Mary. She walked out on him and there wasn't a thing he could do about it.
I know that, but he loves Mary.
Yeah, and he ran after her and he fell down and he could barely get up. Donna, he bleeds just like the rest of us.
But it made him angry, Michael. He doesn't like to lose.
Honey, he's already lost. And he's holding on to you like a drowning man. Don't let him take you down with him.
I don't know what to do.
Donna, don't let him win, all right? He only gets stronger if you do. Honey, this is our chance to turn this around. You just have to trust me.
I do trust you.
Okay, then don't be afraid. Donna, I love you. I can't take you away from all this, all right? This is our time together. Now, you want it, don't you?
Yes.
Okay, then if you want it, you take it. Honey, don't be afraid. You can be free now. Honey, give us the time that Reginald took away from us 20 years ago. Marry me now.
Oh, Michael.
Donna, this is our last chance. Will you marry me? Donna.
Well, I can't put out an APB on them until they've been missing for 24 hours.
There's got to be something that we can do, MJ.
Look, relax. I talked to Bridget. She said they were heading north. That's Bloomfield County.
Can you call the police there?
I can already. The problem is that there's only two guys in the entire sheriff's department.
Oh, well, that's just wonderful. Can they do anything?
Yes, they're looking for him. Look, I'm sure that they just, probably their car broke down.
Then why didn't they call?
Well, you know how desolate it is up there. Maybe they just couldn't get to a phone.
I don't like this. Maybe Cass and I should drive up.
No. Stay put, all right? I'll be out of here in a little while. If we haven't heard anything by then we'll figure out what to do, all right? Just sit tight.
All right. Bye.
MJ's gonna come by and then we'll decide what to do.
Well, let's not get all worked up, okay? Scott's a level-headed guy.
Yeah, he's not gonna let anything happen to Cheryl.
She's just a kid, Cass.
Hey, this kid hid out for a week in Bay City after she ran away from the nuns, remember?
Now, Scott and Cheryl can take care of themselves.
Set up for you and the kids.
I think you're right.
You'll come.
You seem surprised.
I am.
Well, why shouldn't I go with you? You're a very important part of my life.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Why don't you show me just kind of as a reminder?
Oh. Yeah, maybe I could.
Reliving old memories?
Will you answer me? Donna, forget about the phone. I am asking you to marry me.
Mike, I can't think.
Hello.
Well, well, well. Is this Mr. Michael Hudson?
Who is this?
Ms. McGee, you remember.
Look, lady, I thought I told you not to call me here.
And here I thought I was getting the private line to Miss Donna Love's bedroom.
Hey, look, just forget this.
Tell me, are you always in Miss Love's boudoir this late at night?
Miss McGee, you leave Donna Love out of this. As a matter of fact, why don't you just forget the whole thing?
Who is that? You know I couldn't do that. After all, I still have several questions to ask you.
No comment.
How about those hot dates with Sybil Shepherd? Was that before or after her divorce?
You are pushing it, honey.
What about those cozy little pictures of you and Jackie O in St. Moritz?
Drop it.
Funny, that's what she said. I wonder why.
Miss McGee, I don't ever want to see your face or hear your voice ever again. Is that clear? Goodbye.
Oh, I'm afraid you're going to hear quite a bit of my voice. Michael Hudson.
You can just forget about the phone call. And you know something? You had the right idea before about that phone and about us, honey.
Michael, I'm really tired.
No. You're not going to get away with that. Now, we're going to settle this right now. Now, as I recall, we were engaged and we were going to have an autumn wedding. Oh, come on, Donna, this is our chance.
What about Daddy?
Your father is still reeling from the shock of losing Mary. He's in no shape to fight.
He'll find out.
So what if he does? I mean, there's not a thing he can do about it. Honey, we can live anywhere you want. We can live anywhere in the world. Donna, this is our chance to be happy. We deserve to be happy.
I know that, Michael, but it's...
No. Then don't deliberate. Don't. Honey, this may be our last chance. Come on.
Michael.
No. We can be happy. And...
It's not that simple.
Yes, it is that simple. Reginald Love can't hurt us.
He can.
No. Donna, we can win this. This is our chance. We've got to take it.
Oh, Michael.
Come on. I want you to say it. I want you to say that you'll marry me. Say yes, Donna. Answer me. What? What is that?
I said, yes, you crazy fool, yes.
Yes?
Yes, 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 yes,
yes.
Yes,
yes, yes, yes. Yes.
Margarita ran out into the rain looking for Enrico, right?
Mm-hmm. Did she ever find him?
Not according to legend.
So what happened?
Well, her father sends out the search party the next morning. The only thing they come back with is one shoe of hers that's planted in the mud opposite this mountain waterfall, okay?
So she died?
That's what they said.
What about Enrico?
His gear was on the other side of the waterfall.
So they never found each other?
Uh-uh.
That's so sad.
No, but wait, you gotta hear the rest of the story, though. Supposedly, every time there's some rainfall, the spirits search out the jungle for each other, hoping to find their eternal happiness.
Think they'll ever find each other?
Yeah, I'm sure they will.
You know, it's really hard to picture you growing up in Paraguay. I mean, I feel like I've known you all my life, like we grew up together or something.
Well, I was born right here in Bay City. I was probably the guy you remember as a baby who used to pull your hair in the park and stuff and used to play with your rattle.
Maybe we went to nursery school together.
I probably stuck bubblegum in your hair a couple times, too.
And I was the one who put chocolate pudding in your face.
I love chocolate pudding. I'm sure we probably saw each other. Probably even played with each other a couple times. I stayed here until I was 4 years old. Here we go.
What about... your natural parents, you think you'll ever find them?
I'm gonna find them. I'm not gonna quit until I do. But I just want you to know I'll never think of anyone besides our mother as my mom. You know, it's something I have to do, though.
I understand. You know, it's really weird us having the same mother.
I know it.
Hey.
What?
You're shivering.
I'm okay.
No, it's not okay. No. Now, how are you going to sleep all night if you're that cold?
I'm fine. It's no problem, okay?
Listen, will you stop being a hero all the time? Now, there's plenty of room here. Are you going to get in or am I going to have to drag you?
You had no right to follow me.
You can believe what you want. I put two and two together. Your maid said Bayview Boulevard, so I came over here.
You shouldn't have.
How did you know this place was still vacant?
It isn't. I never gave up the lease.
You mean after all these years? You've kept the place where we lived?
It was a business decision. You didn't read anything into it.
I remember this. Matthew took it everywhere he went.
It was his security blanket. About the apartment.
What about it?
I thought it might make a nice studio. I've always loved this part of town. It's far from the hustle and bustle. It wasn't a sentimental decision, if that's what you're thinking.
How do you know what I'm thinking?
It just doesn't mean anything.
I heard you.
I mean it.
This place doesn't mean anything, do you? I don't mean anything to you.
No, you don't.
I don't believe you.
Leave me alone.
Do you want to know what it means to me to be back here with you?
Doesn't mean anything.
Knowing that you kept this place?
I just told you why.
I have feelings. I know you have feelings.
I don't.
Matthew knows.
No.
So what are we going to do about it?
I shouldn't have come here. It was a bad idea.
It was a good idea. We were happy here.
You have a very selective memory.
Maybe. Maybe it wasn't perfect. But we had a chance. We had a chance for a good life. Until things got complicated.
They got complicated because we're wrong for each other.
Oh, really? Were we wrong when we sat in front of that window and watched the sun come up? Were we wrong when we worked side by side, sometimes throughout the night? No. What we had was right. I look around. You want to know what I feel? Being here, I know that I can reach out and I can touch something that I love. And why can't you admit that? Don't run away from me, Rachel. Rachel.
She's 17, almost 18. She has blonde hair. Thank you. And that was the last hospital.
Well, no news is good news, right?
Yeah, right. Look, Scott and Cheryl are going to be okay.
Any news?
No. Nothing.
I called all the hospitals and there haven't been any bad accidents.
Oh, Jamie, I'm glad you're here. We're trying to keep this from Vincent. You can help.
Speaking of which, I guess I should get over to the house and let him know that, I don't know, Cheryl is spending the night with Nancy.
Good. And I guess I'll hit the back roads out behind the Love Estate and head out towards Lookout Point.
Lookout Point?
Yeah, well, maybe they went parking. Well, better not to speculate.
Yeah, please.
Why don't we hit the towing services and garages and see if they call them?
That's a great idea, thanks.
Okay. And Ada, why don't you stick by the phone and we'll keep checking in until we find those two kids, all right?
Fasten your seatbelts. It's gonna be a long night.
You know, our families must be worried sick about us.
Yeah, especially Pops.
Yeah.
Now, is that better? Don't you feel warmer?
Yeah. You know something?
What?
We've known each other about 8 weeks.
Uh-huh.
Already been to bed twice.
Good thing we're friends, huh?
I think we might as well admit it. We're more than just that.
Yeah, I guess so.
I'm getting sick of us having to sneak around all the time.
What do you mean?
I mean, as soon as we get back to Bay City, I'm going to try and find my natural parents. And we're going to start seeing each other out in the open.
Pops is not going to like that.
If Vince explodes, he explodes. I can deal with that.
Are you sure?
I can deal with just about anything. Except trying to sleep like this.
Why? What's wrong?
Never mind.
Does this bother you?
No, not a bit.
We're gonna be happy, Blackie. You do believe that, don't you?
As long as you're with me.
Well, I will be. Always. And we'll be married.
Yes.
And Reginald Love will be defeated and beaten. So good to have you back in my arms.
I missed you so much.
Well, I'm so happy you're not afraid anymore.
This part of Another World was brought to you by today's Zest Deodorant Bar. Zest lathers you clean, then rinses you cleaner than soap. You're not fully clean unless you're zestfully clean. Join us each weekday for the continuing story of Another World.